Let's add a navigation menu to the basic Bootstrap layout that we've already created. Select the first row of the Bootstrap layout. At the bottom, we're going to select div.column-sm-12.tagSelector, located at the bottom of the code panel. And once we have that tag selector selected, we can click delete. Now, since we've deleted that, the cursor is just where we want it to add our new navigation element. We're going to go to insert, and then we're going to click on the navbar, basic navbar item under Bootstrap components, and we are going to select the nest option. Now, let's give ourselves a little bit more room to take a look at this. We'll use the scrub bar to open it up, and we still want to be able to see what's going on in our code, but we also want to be able to see what we need to select in the navbar. Okay, there we go. Well, we've got a lot of things here that we don't need. So the first thing that we're going to get rid of is the drop-down menu on the right side. Click on the drop-down menu. We're going to select ul.nav.navbar-nav.navbar-right tag selector, and then we're going to click delete. Alrighty, that was easy enough. You're going to check carefully and just make sure you deleted what you intended to delete. Select carefully. The next thing we're going to click on is the search field. Okay, now we're going for form.nav-form.navbar-left. So we're looking for a beginning with form. We're going to click on form, and then we see what we need to delete is selected. We see that in the live view HUD. And we're going to click delete. Well, that was easy peasy again. Now we're going to click the drop-down menu in the menu bar, still something else we don't need. And we're going for li.dropdown. Let's find that in our tag selector at the bottom. And we're going to click delete. Awesome. Okay, now we're almost finished. Now you can use brand as a place to put a logo or a link to your homepage, but for what we're doing right now, we don't need it. We're going to click on brand, and then we're going to find a.navbar-brand tag selector. Click on the A. We're going to see that it's selected correctly in the HUD, and we can see it over in the HTML as well. We're going to click delete. Okay, that's great. Now, save everything. Click file save. Just to be on the safe side, I always click file save all. Now we're going to click the first link item to select it. And now we're going to double-click on the first link item. Now you'll see, once we double-click, we have an orange box surrounding it. So I'm going to highlight the first word link, and I'm going to replace it with home. And then I'm not going to click enter because that could accidentally delete it. I'm just going to click outside of that orange box. Pay close attention to this, just clicking outside of that orange box. Okay, great. That's returned where I would like it to be. If you click escape or enter or anything like that, you might discard rather than replace with different text. Now, let's try that again. This one's a little trickier. I'm going to double click. First, I click there. Now, I'm going to double click inside this link box. I've selected link. I'm going to double click. And then I'm going to select the text that's inside that box. I'll just start selecting from inside the box, and then I can start typing green news. And once in a while it's kind of all over the place like this, but here I can see I just have an extra K, so I'm going to use the arrow to go forward, and then I'm going to hit my backspace button one time. Now remember, I don't hit enter, I don't hit escape. I'm going to click outside of that orange box and watch what happens. See, now great, now it's exactly where I want it to be. Now in live view, I'm going to click on the green news link, and then I'm going to go down to the tag selector at the bottom, and I'm going to hit LI, list element tag selector, and now I'm going to go to my insert, and now I'm going to go to my HTML, and I'm going to select list item option. Now my position assist interface appears, and I'm going to click after. Now I need to double click and get my orange box so that I can edit. I'm going to click inside that placeholder text, and I'm going to double click, and I have my orange box that allows me to edit. I'm going to highlight this text, and I'm going to replace that with green events. And remember, I'm going to click outside of the orange box. Now you'll notice this looks kind of different than the others do. Let's look in the code and see what's different. It's lacking the hyperlink placeholder markup. So what are we going to do about that? We're going to select the text green events in code view. And now in the property inspector, so we're going to go to windows. If the property inspector isn't showing, we're going to go to window, and then we're going to select properties. And we don't have a real link now. We just wanted to act like it's a link. So we're going to put a pound sign there, and that sort of holds a place for the actual link. It'll still look like a link and display all the same characteristics as a link, but it won't have anywhere to go and it won't be a dead link. So I'm going to put the pound sign, and then I'm going to click enter. After creating the link in green events, click file, save all. Now, here's where your instructions can get a little hinky. I've got to vary from them slightly to get this to work as directed. Your instructions tell you to insert the cursor at the end of the text green events and press enter return to create a new line in live view. But if in live view, I insert the cursor at the end of the text green events and press enter return to create a new line, you'll notice that what I am actually is on the same line as green events. In order to create that new line, I've got to hit enter one more time. So now I can type green travel. And now I can highlight green travel, carefully just green travel. My hyperlink option pops up in live view. And instead of a URL, I'm going to put the pound sign as my placeholder for the URL. And then I'm going to click away outside of the orange box. And then I notice here in my HTML, I have indeed added a new list element. The directions as written in your textbook, I haven't been able to get them to work that way either. I have to hit enter twice and then it works just fine. Hitting enter once puts it on the same line as green events. Next, we're going to put our cursor inside the green travel link. And then at the bottom, we're going to select LI. And then we can right click and copy. Hit enter, control V. And then we're going to place tips instead of travel. Now we'll create two more links any way that we like, and our menu is complete. If you want to clean up your code a little bit, just left click inside of the code view and come over to the icon that says Format Source Code, left click on it, and select Apply Source Formatting. And that's very helpful when you've been copy and pasting or deleting, bringing things in and out. This just helps you clean up and get your code much more user-friendly. Once you're accustomed to working with Bootstrap, this will be a pretty zippy process. Now, let's do just a bit of tidying up. I'm going to go back to Split View. I'm going to select and delete the attribute class active from the first list element in Code View. And now I'm going to delete the span class for screen readers only from the first list element as well. Now, making sure I didn't inadvertently remove any tags or add anything I didn't intend to add. And that's looking pretty good. Now we're ready to make it beautiful.